Secretary of State, because of the New Deal and then World War II, command and control economy. This is when federal power really reached its zenith. So there are those who say that because there hasn't been a case about the 10th Amendment in over 70 years, it can't mean that much anymore. Well, let me suggest to you this. If that's true, then it ought to be true about the Second Amendment as well, right? Because if there hadn't been a case before D.C. v. Heller, which was just decided by the Supreme Court recently, since the 1930s. But I'm sure you noticed that when the United States Supreme Court struck down the District of Columbia's handgun ban on Second Amendment grounds, that they didn't have any trouble reaching that conclusion because, you know, even though it had been many years since there had been a Second Amendment case before them. What that tells us is that the Constitution, including the Bill of Rights, does not become old or feeble or outdated. It's just as strong and just as important today as it was 70 years ago, 170 years ago, or 220 years ago, right? It's still our Constitution. As a lawyer and a lover of our country and the law, it is such a privilege to get to speak about the greatest document for organizing a society of free individuals ever lost. It is just such a privilege. I think about it when I go to the U.S. Supreme Court to argue cases. It matters. And when you're in front of the Supreme Court, let me tell you, if you don't think the Constitution matters, you're disabused of that as soon as you get in front of all nine of those justices. Because whether they're left or right or center, they all care deeply about the Constitution. It is a living document in the sense of being applied. I don't mean in the sense of it changing every day, don't get me wrong. But I mean, it really means something when you're in front of the U.S. Supreme Court.
I have a question for all of these gentlemen. If you take your seat in the Congress in January of next year, will you move to cancel all expenditures on the Stonewall fiasco? Oh, if you don't know what the Stonewall fiasco is, ask me, I'll explain it to you.
You're referring to the dams? To the dams?
Yeah.
Absolutely. If they don't start that job soon enough, I can guarantee you, we'll find some way to either pigeonhole some money that Greg Barnes can so use to use as well, or we'll pigeonhole and say, spend it unless you stop it. We won't let you spend money on the program. We'll do something. It's ridiculous. It's not scientifically based. I've read a little bit about it. I tried to make an effort to read the local paper for the past 3 months. I gotta tell you, there's no science behind it. There's always this contradicting science. Or we run them off, but yes,
I would support efforts to reopen the issue, and I think that's really what would be appropriate to see what the science is right now. It's been 15 years, I think, since it was decided. But I would prefer to be a little bit less precipitous on that, but I would support a revisit of that issue.
Well, you both talked about people that are career senators and representatives and everything. Chances are we're probably never going to get a bill passed saying that you can only be in there for a certain amount of terms. But since both of you mentioned that you're very adamant about career senators are not effective after a while, would you be willing to say, hey, after 3 terms or 4 terms or something, I'm willing to set it out and let a fresh face take a chance at it?
Well, the Constitution